Today we're at Ashfield Boys High School for East Belfast Speaks Out. I'm Carl, reporting for WIMPS.tv.
How do you think the event tonight went?
I think it went really, really well. We had a good lot of people here from East Belfast, and I think I was really impressed at the breadth of different issues that people here feel so strongly about that they'd give up their Wednesday night to come along here and put their hand up and ask to the people that are supposed to represent them.
I'm sure, as most people in East Belfast are, they're a wee bit disappointed with the peace wall having to go up in St Matthew's. Some people might say it's a step backwards, and also it's not a good idea as the chapel can be used as an attacking ground for Pip Park.
Yeah, well, I've volunteered as an interface worker previously in the area, so I know what the situation has been like previously, and it is disappointing, but the local residents feel that it merits it at this particular time. But we, as elected representatives, people in the community, we've got to work together to create the situation where all the good cross-community work that has happened in that area is developed further.
Do you think it's right that a peace wall should go up over a building where it's been used to attack people in Pip Park?
Well, I think there's an issue that where there's an immediate concern, you have to put some sort of physical barrier in place. But you've got to realise the real barriers that you're taking down are not the physical ones, but they're the barriers in people's heads. And what I always do when I bring tourists here is I take them to where those peace walls are. And, you know, you can walk about 100 yards and you can walk round to the other side. It's not like it goes on for miles, but it's really people's attitudes that need to be changed, and that comes from young people like yourselves talking to other young people and saying there's more that unites us, you know, than divides us.
What can MLAs like yourself do to help unemployed youth in East Belfast?
Well, I've been working with the Minister for Employment and Learning and local companies to set up rapid impact youth employment schemes. The Minister himself has invested a significant amount of money in the youth employment scheme here in Northern Ireland, so any young people who are in need of opportunities, I'd be glad to meet with them in person and tell them about a number of the schemes that are there and available to them.
What you have to realise is that employers don't buy qualifications, they buy skills. Now, qualifications, if they're done right, are a good thing to say, I've got these skills, but ultimately skills is where it's all at. The second thing that we can do when we're a parliament is it's good to bring young people up to actually shadow us in government, to let us know how people are looking at things, what are the real pressures, how they're feeling about things. But it's better that it's not just old grey men in parliament. We need younger people, younger voices, telling us what the reality is like at the door.
It was mentioned tonight about bringing events like this around Northern Ireland. How do you think that can be done?
I think that's a difficult question. That's one that I'm looking for an answer on that. I think having folks like WIMPS come along to events and asking questions and showing that young people are actually interested in politics and want to be involved in making political decisions, that shows me that there's people out there in our society, young and old, who would be interested in being part of something like this. I think I'd love to see Northern Ireland speaking out. I'd love to see different areas across Northern Ireland where people come together and they just talk about the stuff that's happening to them in their lives and ask questions to the people who make the decisions in our society. So it's a tough question to answer, but it's one that we're really looking for an answer to that.